When you're running a GS4 drive in sensorless vector mode, it's a really good idea to run the drive's built-in auto-tune on the connected motor so you get the absolute best performance out of your GS4 drive, which, at the end of the day, saves you money in operating cost. Auto-tune measures the actual stator resistance and no-load current and puts them in these parameters if you have the Motor 1 auto-tune parameter selected. There's a second set of auto-tune parameters where you can save and use the data for a second motor. You could enter them manually from the vendor's datasheet if you want to, but auto-tune is so quick and easy, it's best just to let the drive measure what it actually sees. Before starting auto-tune, disconnect the motor from any load. Normally, you would even remove the pulley. I'm going to leave it on for this demo, so it's easier for you to see the motor spinning. Now, if you can't separate the motor from the load, then check out the static auto-tune section later in this video. Make sure the drive and motor are wired correctly and work as expected. Looks good. Double check that these parameters are set to the numbers shown on the motor's faceplate. Motor output voltage? Yep. Rated current? Yep. Base frequency? Yep. Rated RPM? Yep. Horsepower? Yep. And number of poles? Great. We've disconnected the load, verified the wiring, and checked the parameters. One more thing, and this is important. Please make sure you have an e-stop connected. You're about to tell the drive to run the motor, and you need a way to shut it down if things don't go as expected. And the best way to do that is to use the drive's built-in STO function. Click on this information banner to see a short video on how to do that. I have this drive set up to run when I press the keypad button when it's in local mode. So, to start the auto-tune process, just set parameter 0.05 to a 1, press enter, and then press run. In a few seconds, the shaft will start spinning and you'll see a flashing auto-tune message. Now, if you have to stop the motor during the process, you'll get an error. Just reset the error and start over again. And of course, you can view the error status in the usual error parameters. Well, looks like auto-tune's finished. Let's go see what it measured. Parameter 0.06 is the stator resistance. Looks reasonable. And parameter 7 is the no-load current, which is what the nameplate says it should be. Perfect. The drive is now auto-tuned and ready to operate at its best possible efficiency. If you couldn't decouple the motor from its load, then you can still do a static auto-tune. It just measures the stator resistance. You have to enter the no-load current from the motor's nameplate or datasheet before you run the test. To run the test, you just enter a 2 in parameter 0.05 instead of the one we did a minute ago. All the other steps are just like we did a minute ago. Since the auto-tuned results are just parameters, if you reset the drive parameters to factory default, the auto-tuned parameters will be reset. So be sure to retune the drive after you do a factory reset of the drive parameters. Click here for more information on the GS4 drive. Click here to learn about all of AutomationDirect's free support options, and click here to subscribe to AutomationDirect's YouTube channel so you'll be notified when we publish new videos.